Hey Airsofters, Fox Airsoft HD here. Today I'm going to show you how to spray paint your helmet snakeskin camo. It's very easy to do, and I'll show you how to do it in the video, so I hope you enjoy it. So the spray paint I use is the Rust-Oleum Camouflage Series. They're very good camouflage spray paints, as well as the Krylon ones. They come in a variety of colors that you would need for camouflage, like OD, tan, brown, black, etc. I'm using the tan for my base coat, but it doesn't matter because you could use whatever camouflage you want. And I'm going to use the brown for the actual snakeskin camo. Now I'm also going to use this Krylon matte finish. Even though the other camos use a matte finish, this one protects it. And I don't know, it's just optional. You don't have to do it, but I want to protect my helmet, unless you want to give it a wear and tear look. So obviously you're going to need some kind of mesh to give it the snakeskin pattern. If you have mesh lying around your house, go ahead and use that. I didn't, so I used some of my pool netting, and it actually works out pretty cool. Just make sure the actual circles within the mesh are pretty small, because if it's too big, it's gonna ruin the effect and it's just not gonna look good at all. So make sure they're pretty small. Lastly, don't forget about safety procedures when spray painting. If you inhale the spray paint, it's very harmful to you. So make sure you have a mask or your t-shirt. So the first thing you're gonna wanna do is shake your spray paint can like you see me doing for about 2 minutes nonstop. It'll give you the best spray paint results, so please do that. Now for your base coat, what you're going to want to do is do at least 3 coats all around the helmet. It'll keep it from getting removed in the long run, and just keep the helmet with the camouflage. Unless you want that kind of wear and tear look, but do at least 3 coats of your base color. Now once you have your base coat dried, what you're going to want to do is take your secondary camouflage color. I'm using one, but you could use multiple. And you're just going to want to make random stripes and marks around the helmet, because that's what's going to start your snakeskin pattern. So now we're going to do the final step. What you're going to want to do is take your mesh material, put it over your helmet, and then just take the color you used for your base coat and just spray paint it over the mesh. That's what's going to give it the snakeskin pattern. And just keep moving around the mesh all over the helmet to get it complete. So now that you're done with the actual camo, you can stylize it to your liking. What I'm actually doing is taking the tan and just randomly covering up the actual camo, just so it's not too flashy. You know, kind of mute it down. I think that looks better in my opinion, but you could do whatever you want to it. So after putting my protective coating on it and letting it dry, it came out amazing. I'm so happy on how it came out. It looks awesome. So click the subscribe button, check out my Facebook fan page and my Twitter. Hope you enjoyed the video. Hope it helped you make this awesome camo, and have a nice day.